Hey, today we are going to convert this 2003 Harley Davidson Fat Boy into hydraulic cam chain tensioners, a hydraulic cam chain chest. We're going to be using the Feuling conversion kit. Real nice, comes with the plate, the cam plate, the oil pump, the hydraulic tensioners, new outer chain and gears, and it's going to be very easy. The kit even comes with the top rockers and everything, the gaskets to make this happen. So, okay, how we unload the cam chest. So I take the spark plugs out. I put the bike into high gear. In this case, it is a 5-speed, so it's fifth gear. I'm going to rotate the rear wheel. That's why we take the spark plugs off, so we can move the engine. And what I'm looking for is the intake rocker shaft to go up and then come down. Once it comes down, just after that is top dead center compression. So once that's down, then we can take the rocker arms off. So it's basically like this, it's exhaust, intake up and down. So here's a closer look at what happens when you spin the rear wheel. Exhaust opens, and then the intake opens. Basically, that's the overlap, an intake, and then boom, top dead center. Push rods. These are two different lengths. Exhaust is longer than the intake. Pop these pushrod tube covers off. There's spring loaded under here, under this collar here, and these caps on top, you just put a screwdriver in and pry it out gently, and it comes out. And there's O-ring down here that sometimes it makes it hard, but all you gotta do is push this part of the pushrod tube up, and it'll come out, and then just repeat. All right, now we're gonna take off the lifter cover here. It's not a bad thing.
What is that?
So there is a retaining pin that keeps the lifters from spinning. That comes out, and then so when I pull the lifter out, I'm gonna mark it. I already marked this one. Rear exhaust. The outside one is the exhaust. And to make sure it stays pumped up, I'm gonna measure these later, but just for now, I have a tub of oil that I keep them in. That way they don't bleed down. And here's the intake. So, rear intake. And process is the same for the front. I'm going to spin the motor over again and take all that stuff off, and then we'll go back to the All right, got the front all torn down, same as the rear. Now I'm gonna get the cam chain off, starting with the tensioners, which is the whole reason why we're doing this job. I've got my Jim's tensioner tools here. Makes this real easy. Basically, this bolt with the slots cut in it will help you open, unload the cam chain tensioner, and it comes with these little pins to retain it. So now that's loose, and so remember the bike is in fifth gear, so we can use that to our advantage. and I will depress the rear brake in order to lock the engine and break these bolts loose. Otherwise, turning them, the engine will just spin, like so. Hold the rear brake to break them loose. Now, probably help us later if we put this in time. Not that the cam matters, it's more for the pinion sprocket here. It has dot, and there's a line on the body of the cam plate. Tells you it's in time. So now, any luck. This should slide off. Like so. And see how the tensioner is worn. A lot of that's because this old style cam chain just eats into it. Oh, jeez.
What's a lot of wheel?
Plug in there to temporarily stop it.
Yeah, but I think it's still going to drip from the bottom.
Alright, one thing you really want to measure is the pinion shaft, which is this shaft here. Pretty much tells you the condition of the crank. If this thing has a lot of run out, then the crank needs to be remanufactured or replaced. This one is really, really good. So basically, it's still in fifth gear. Just spin the rear wheel. And you can see that the run out is just about a thousandth, which is very, very good for these. I mean, from Harley, I mean, I've seen them as far out as like 12, so pretty good. All right, I got the parts all cleaned up. I got the engine cleaned, the engine case cleaned. Most of the parts, I didn't go too crazy on the cams because I don't know what I'm gonna have to do to them to make this case or this these components work. So here's the Feuling 7090 OE Plus hydraulic cam chain conversion kit. So comes with, these are inner cam bearings. Here's the OE Plus oil pump. Pretty cool. Gotta tear that apart and lube it, clean it. This is the outer sprocket. These are the new tensioners, hydraulic. This is the cam plate. All right, now we gotta push these bearings into the new cam plate, which I have cleaned. I have the Jim's tools to do it. Makes everything, these bearings are very critical, they get pressed in straight. So, cam plate goes on, tool, and that. Bearing receiver goes on. That's butter, and it locates it and it puts it to the correct depth. And I lube these with a little bit of WD-40 just to aid in the pressing.
Like a bee.
So the roller bearing and front. Wash my hands. Roller bearing on the front, nut bearing in the back. Now I gotta install the race for the cam. And I'll do that. Let me get set up and I'll do that. And I need to install the race onto the cam. This tool here. Just like that. Right now, I gotta do some other little work before I have to go back to the press and press the cams into the cam plate. I'm gonna install the bearing retainer, these little screws, get just a small drop of Loctite. Now this bolt, or this plug, would go into this hole here for a twin cam A motor in a bagger or a dyna. This is a B motor, so it's balanced, and this is an oil port that feeds oil to the balancer in the crankcase. So we're going to leave that out. Putting the cams back in. So it's very important that they get timed properly with the new chain. And these ones, these cams, on the inside, they have two dashes, and those dashes get lined up. Now, this bearing race goes in the roller bearing, and this one gets pressed into the ball bearing. So it's very important that you have the tools to do this. This, the Jim's tools will properly pressure on the inner race of the bearing that we're pressing in. You don't want to press on the outer bearing and put pressure on the actual balls because it'll damage the bearing. So we double check. And I have a assembly lube in the bearings and on here and on this cam. And then the cap, this will help make sure these go down evenly. And you just want to press it slowly and just be very mindful of anything that doesn't look right. If it doesn't look right, it probably isn't right. So you want to make sure, it's try to get it as straight as possible. You really only have one chance to do this right without destroying the bearing, so. It was in very minimal effort. Something's going on here. What I'm pressing seems good, but the other one doesn't. Okay. It's just being held in by. This is putting pressure on it. Now they go down even nice. I'm just gonna do it to the bottoms. Boom. And then before we get too crazy, we want to verify that it's still in time. Alright, yeah, so luckily there's dashes on the front here too, so they're still in line, so we're good. And these tools are very, very important for this. Any galling of the cam plate or a bearing's not pressing straight will seriously affect the longevity of this setup that we have here. Okay, now we're going to take out these inner cam bearings here. Once I get them out, I'll show you the difference between the stock Harley ones, which are prone to failure, and a full complement bearing. This part of the remover just presses into the bearing, a little shaft goes in. The collar goes over top of it, but you have to make sure that the part that has a recessed goes in. If this part goes out, the bearing will have, as you pull the bearing out, have no place to go and it'll get smashed and it'll end up inside the crankcase, which is a very bad day. Ask me how I know that. So that, if you don't have it in the right way, it'll go into the case and the whole engine has to come apart to fix it. Those little needle bearings, you can't leave them in the case. They will destroy everything. It's harder than most steel that's in here. So basically, you just hold it with one. There's flats on here. You hold it with a 9/16 wrench, and then you just tighten it. And it's kind of difficult, but you'll feel it start to move. And once it starts to move, it's smooth sailing. So if it was super, super tight right now, I would take it off and double check that I have it in there right. You don't want these things, you don't want to do this wrong. This is one thing you don't want to do wrong. Okay, and the bearing is in there now. So all I'll do is pull this stuff out, shaft, and the bearing. So I don't know if you can see that, but there's a roller bearing and then there's a race. Roller bearing, race, roller bearing, race. Just prone to failure. What we're looking for is a full complement bearing. Like the Timken one that we're gonna replace it. If you can see, it's all roller bearing and there's no cage in there to separate the bearings, which I have no and plus, they're a lot wider. These bearings go all the way to the outside, and these ones are not as big, so much more support. So anytime I'm in the cam chest, I just replace these bearings. I've seen them fail, and one bad thing about when they fail is if the bearing race itself spins, it destroys the bore in the case. All right, now we're gonna install these full complement bearings. See that? Yeah, there you go. Bearings all the way around, no race. Very important upgrade. So I got my Jim's installer tool. Basically thread the shaft in there. And then this thing comes with two different size heads. Depending on the bearing, those 7 and newers are a little bit bigger. So the new bearing. Now these bearings have writing on one side and not the other. You want to press it on the side with the writing, as the lip on the race is a little bit bigger, more supportive. A little bit of light oil on there. And this plate uses these screws to, all right, now it's nice and sturdy. So I'm gonna thread the bearing in, thread the shaft in, which is gonna push the bearing, and you can see through the top. I won't be able to show you, but you just wanna make sure it goes in straight. Double check, and then you just take a ratchet and tighten it down. This tool is nice because there's a lip on the part that presses it in, and it'll stop when it's get at the right depth, so you don't really have to worry about it. Yep, there, it stopped. These. And your bearing's installed. You should repeat the process for the other side. Move this shaft to this hole. Do the same thing. Okay, and I'm going to install the tensioner under the block on the inside. So Feuling wants you to use Molly Lube.
on the threads as well as the head of the bolt and torque it to 120 inch pounds.
Alright, now I'm going to assemble the oil pump here. First things first. Put assembly lube inside it. Here's the cam plate and the assembly lube on this surface. Just drop a little bit of oil in there. And this is the same procedure. We use Molly lube on the threads and then the head. It's ARP Ultra Torque that comes with the kit. That way we can get an exact amount of torque when we torque this down. Installs like so. Before we go any further, on the back of the oil pump, you put the O-ring, put some assembly lube on it. Place that there. Alright, after some trial and error, I decided to put the pump in first, so I can make sure it gets the O-ring in and the gear rotors line up with the oil pump, or the pinion shaft. So now I can install, make sure I'm indexing cams into the, you also need to lube this pinion shaft and the bearing, or the bushing there. Proper torque. Wash my hands now. All right, I'm gonna spin the rear wheel to check for any kind of any binding. And also the center of the oil pump. I'm gonna tighten these down. Just my wrench. Their spec is 10 inch pounds and I have no way to do that, so. Light pressure with yep, feels good still. Now my final torque of 120 inch pounds.
more time.
Nice pattern. Just lightly.
Do 45 inch pounds.
I'm spinning the wheel every time I torque two bolts,
so I can see if any binding is going on. Because what we're trying to do here is center the oil pump on the shaft, because it's pretty much free floating and is dictated, the center of it is dictated by these bolts. So you have to spin it to make sure everything gets aligned. So here's 90 inch pounds.
Double check everything.
And there's the cam plate. Cam still spins smoothly. Some more assembly lube on these bearings. All right, now we got to make sure the sprocket alignment is correct. So I have the pinion gear on. I'm going to install the cam gear. Put it in time. So I got this dot here and wants to line up with this the line on the cam plate. And this gear goes on. So, a little bit of Molly lube on this bolt. Okay, we want to get this sprocket alignment as close as possible. So basically, we're going to run a straight edge along the flat part of the pinion gear and the flat part of the cam gear. I'm going to hold it tight so there's no rocking, and then take my feeler gauge and feel the gap there. In this case, it's 23 thousandths, so I know we can do better. Feeling sent a whole sleeve, so I need to see what is in there. I just put the stock one in there, and then we'll. So the cam gear is below the pinion gear, so we need to make a bigger shim to raise it out. In this case, we have a 317. We'll put in a 337 to give it 20 thousandths more. If this is the case, we should be right about 3 thousandths, give or take, which is good. I want to say the spec is like 8, but I'm not 100% sure on that. And so the closer we can get it, the better. We're at 6 thousandths. Time the gears here. So they're timed and installed.
check everything. Looks good. Now the good thing about keeping this in fifth gear is you can use the brake. Torque these down. Okay, now I'll go 15 foot-pounds. And then loosen one full rotation. Alright, then we have 24 on this bolt and 34 on that bolt. On the pinion it's 24 and on the cam sprocket it's 34. Alright, now I'll rotate it and double check timing. And I also want to lube these gears really. Lube the chain. So now I'm going to take my fueling lifter, or not lifter, what do you call this thing? Tensioner. Lube it up pretty, really good. Line those holes. And stick the pin in. And then the same thing for these bolts that we've been doing. These get the ultra torque and the threads. Alright, these bolts get 120 inch pounds. Much easier when everything's stationary. And then I'll look, verify everything. And that's how you install that. Feuling hydraulic conversion conversion setup. Feuling hydraulic or spring loaded tensioners to hydraulic setup. So we have a better oil pump, better cam plate. This thing should be nice and quiet. Lifter bores are perfect or within spec.